I'm going to do the details on the top handle now. Alt-click on that subtool to select it, and I'll go to the texture menu, image plane, reference views. Dial back the model opacity, and we'll zoom in. So, from the look of it here, we've got a couple screws here, and we've got a section that's beveled in right there. So let's see if I can't find a brush that will actually take on. That look. And I think this brush is actually going to do it. Yep, that's what I'm looking for. So what I will do is mask out this area, turn on lazy mouse, backtrack, line, snap to track, and I'm using this alpha number, let's find the number on it, 18 on the standard brush, because it's going to give me this very similar recessed V shape, just like so. So if I go to my texture, turn the model opacity back up, you should see the effect that that gives us. I might even do that deeper. I'm going to go to the planar cut brush, drag rectangle stroke, alpha 14, go to my brush menu, depth, I'm going to turn embed down, and I'll turn that down even further. I'm going to add a subdivision level. And I'm going to change to a different view, since I'm not able to really see very clearly what's happening here. I'm going to actual size. I'm going to zoom in on just that particular subtool. It's not cutting in nearly as deep as I want, so it's planar cut. My embed setting is pretty low. That should be going in much deeper than that. Z intensity is turned all the way up. Build that up by hitting replay stroke a few times, and that works just fine. Hit replay last, and then that'll build that in even deeper. And we'll do the same thing up here. Okay. Now we want to add our bolt in there. I'm going to save my work. We're going to make a different bolt for these areas, because it looks like a little Allen wrench bolt. It looks a little bit different. So I'm going to save this. File, save as.